Hello, Prism Engineering SOLIDWORKS community. This is Aaron Winthers. I'm one of the applications engineers here at Prism Engineering. Thank you for checking out our video on how to manage configurations in SOLIDWORKS. This video is a segment from our monthly webinar straight from support. If you'd like to check out other segments from this episode, please be sure to check out the links in the video description. And also, please do join us the second Tuesday of every month when we present straight from support. All right, now we're going to get into our topic. What we're going to be talking about today is how do you manage configurations, particularly in a multi-level assembly. So we're not going to be going in detail as to how you configure, but we're going to be asking ourselves, all right, starting from the part level and building ourselves up a few levels, how do we handle configuring an assembly? All right, so let's go ahead and configure. So I'm going to pop right over to SOLIDWORKS here. And then what you see is that we're starting at the part level. And my goal here with this skateboard wheel that was developed by Toby Schnars is I want to be able to have a smooth version of this part, and also I want to be able to have a grooved version of this part. All right, so first thing I'm going to do is show you that I have a couple features here that are suppressed, and unsuppressing these features will actually give me the grooves that I'm looking for. And in order to do this, I'm going to click on my top node just to make sure that I'm configuring from the top level, not making a derived configuration, and I'll right-click, and I'll say Add Configuration. So I'm going to click on the letter A just because I just want to keep it simple. And then if you guys notice down here in the bottom, under Advanced Options, I do have something checked called Suppressed Features. That basically means if another configuration suppresses a particular feature or adds a feature, it won't be added to this one because this is checked. If this was unchecked and there was another configuration adding a feature or suppressing a feature as an example, then it would add it because I didn't have that checked. All right, so let me go ahead and green check here. I'll right-click, add another configuration. We're going to call this one Configuration B. And again, my goal is to create one that's smooth and one that's not. So this one, because these guys are suppressed, they're smooth, or it's smooth. And then I'll double-click on B. I want to make him my grooved version, so I'm going to control-select both of these guys and then unsuppress. So now I test it. I go between the two, and then I see I have a smooth version and I have a grooved version, A and B. All right, so now what we're going to do is we are going to come back to our presentation here. And again, when you're dealing with configurations at the part level, the main way that you want to configure them is add a configuration on your configuration tab, and then you can name it what you like. Make sure you keep in mind whether or not you want features suppressed in that configuration or not. If you do, go ahead and hit that check. All right, so let's take it one level up. So we still have our part level here. And then now what we're going to do is add an assembly. Now, you'll notice that the names of the files are not exactly the same as, or actually completely different from what you would see here in the presentation. I did that for simplicity's sake. But what I want to do now is just start off with one plain old default assembly at the assembly level. I'm sorry, one default configuration at the assembly level. And I want to configure the assembly to either call for a smooth version of the part or a grooved version of the part. All right, so why don't we go ahead and see how that's done. Come back to SOLIDWORKS, and I'm going to control tab over to the wheel assembly. And then what you see here, it's basically just calling for the wheel component and also a couple other components in this assembly. And then I only have one default configuration. If you want to call for something different, then all you have to do is click on the component you care about. And if it has configurations, it allows you to be able to choose them here. All right, so I'll go ahead and choose A. Green check, and of course that stays smooth because remember, A is supposed to be a smooth configuration. I'll come over here and choose B, green check, and it calls for the B configuration of the part. And since it's calling for the B configuration of the part, that's why I have grooves. All right, so that's a way that you can configure from a default configuration two different versions from the part level. All right. Now, what if we wanted to change that up? What if we wanted to have two different configurations at the assembly level? One of them is going to be the smooth configuration of the assembly, and it's going to call for the smooth configuration of the part, or the A configuration. And then also you're going to have another one that is a grooved configuration in the assembly, and it's going to call for a grooved version of the part. All right, well, let's see how to do that. So I'm going to come back over to here, go to my configuration tab, and then I'm going to right-click Add Configuration. We'll call this one C. And then right-click Add Configuration, we'll call this one D. You have similar options as you do at the part level in terms of suppressing features, but there are assembly features that would be suppressed in mates, and also new components. We don't really care about that. We're only caring about what components we're calling for, so this is not going to affect us. All right, so we have our two configurations. Now, my goal is, again, I want the C version to be smooth. And how do I ensure that? Click on it and make sure that he's associated with A. And he is, because A is the smooth version of the component or the part level. Double-click on D, come back over to here, and then I click down here and I see, all right, let's go ahead and green check that, and I have a grooved version. So test it. I have a smooth version and a groove version with two completely separate configurations. All right. So now we'll come back to our presentation here, and what did we just cover? We went one level up, and we said, all right, starting from the part level, we have a grooved version and smooth version. We brought in a nice wheel assembly, and we said, well, I just want to test, can that guy call for a smooth version of the part, and can he also call for a grooved version of the part? And then after that, we said, let's split it up, and let's ask for two different configurations, one where it only refers to a smooth version, another one where it only refers to a grooved version. All right, now, what happens if we wanted to go two levels up? It starts to get a little bit more complex, so you're going to notice that I have labels next to my parts and assemblies now. The wheel part, again, has an A configuration that's smooth and a B configuration that's smooth. The wheel assembly has a C configuration that's smooth and a D configuration that's smooth. Now, we're going to bring in a truck assembly. And again, the name doesn't match, but it's just for simplicity's sake. We want to create a smooth configuration, letter E, and then a grooved configuration, letter F. All right. Come back over to SOLIDWORKS, Control Tab, and we're going to come over to our assembly. And it's similar. I mean, you can go into your feature tree, and I can say I want to refer that to a particular configuration of a subassembly. And again, the subassembly I'm looking at is the wheel subassembly. And then similarly, you can come over here, click on this tab, and then start configuring. So again, I said I wanted a configuration E and a configuration F. So I'm going to go ahead and right-click, actually click on my top node just to make sure that I've got everything associated with the top level, add configuration, and I'm going to call this one configuration E. Then I'll right-click again, and then I'm going to add another configuration and call this configuration F. All right, so let's go ahead and activate configuration E. And then what I want to do is I'll just go ahead and click on the part, see if I can find that in the tree. And then I'll say, all right, great, he's associated with A, great. And then what happens is, because I know he's way down, if I change his configuration, that should affect all the other configurations as well. All right, so let's go over to the other configuration, configuration F. Now I'm going to click on that part again in the feature tree. That'll open up the assembly that he's in, make him easier to find. Go ahead and click on this guy. Let me click on him again just to make sure I got him. There he is. And I'm going to associate him with configuration B. All right, so now, both of them updated because I updated from the part level. It updates everything else. Let me go test. But wait a minute. Configuration E is now grooved. I thought it was supposed to be smooth. All right, well, let me see if I can fix this. Let's go back to configuration E. I'll click on the part again, and then I'll change them back to configuration A of the part because I know that that one's smooth, right? Go ahead and green check. So it should be smooth. And then hopefully configuration F would be grooved, but it's not. So what happened? Maybe this is a problem that you've seen before. You're trying to figure out how to get all these configurations to work. As soon as you add that next level, things become complicated. So this is what's going on. I started off with two smooth configurations, configuration E and configuration F. They are both smooth. And I said, I want to focus on F and I want to make him grooved. And the way I'm going to do that is to call for configuration B at the part level. But what I forgot, and you guys might have noticed, as soon as I came into the truck assembly, I configured both configuration E and F to configuration C of the wheel assembly. And I did that because I configured the default assembly to configuration C. And then all I did was create new configurations, and it copied the fact that it had the configuration C associated with it, because that's what I did to the default. All right, since configuration F was associated with configuration C, and also since configuration C at the subassembly level was calling for configuration B of the part, what that means is now the wheel assembly, configuration C, is going to become grooved. And since it's connected to configuration F, that's going to become grooved. Now, what I also didn't consider, again, is that configuration E as well was still connected to configuration C at the wheel assembly level. Now, these guys are both referring to the exact same subassembly, namely the wheel subassembly, and particularly configuration C, because that's what I started with. I didn't go back and change anything specifically. And then, because that's the case, guess what? Configuration E will become grooved as well. Then I said, well, let me go back and try to fix it. So I started with configuration A. I want him to be smooth now. Went down into the part level, and I said, I'm going to call for A. And notice I clicked on the wheel, went all the way down into the part level, and completely skipped the subassembly level for the wheel assembly. And then because I skipped it, I forgot that it was connected. And also there was a connection from configuration C down to the part level. When he calls for part A, the subassembly now becomes smooth. And since he called for that smooth configuration and it affects the subassembly, it also affects configuration E. So he becomes smooth. And also, again, configuration F is still connected to configuration C at the subassembly level. And since he's now smooth, and they're referring to the same guy, namely this one, he becomes smooth as well. So the basic problem is they're referring to the same subassembly. That same subassembly is calling for the same configuration of the part. Everything propagates up to everything that's connected. This is not the way that you really want to handle it. So what's the better way of handling it? The better way of handling it is to think of a nice daisy chain. Keep things in series. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to establish a connection from configuration A at the part level to configuration C at the subassembly level, and from configuration C at the subassembly level directly to configuration E at the truck assembly level. And then we'll do the same thing on the other side. All right? So let's go ahead and see how we do that. So when I come back over, my goal is to double-click on the first assembly and then make sure that I call for a configuration that will be smooth. And I know that the C configuration is associated with something smooth or with smooth wheels. And then I also know that this guy is associated with smooth wheels. So it looks like that one's okay. Let me double-click on F. And then I want to right-click on this guy. And then I'm going to choose configuration D, because I know that the subassembly, the wheel subassembly, configuration D is associated with a grooved pattern at the part level. So go ahead and click on D, green check. Now when I switch between the two, I have a smooth version for configuration E and a grooved version for configuration F. So again, what we're trying to do is daisy chain straight up. I know that if I call for part or configuration A, he's smooth. And then I'm going to make configuration C the smooth version and attach that directly to configuration E. I'll do the same thing on the other side. Configuration B is calling for a grooved version. I'm going to associate that with configuration D, and I know that he's grooved. And then I'll associate that with configuration F. So keeping that daisy chain keeps things in order, and you can have a nice predictable configuration all the way from the top level down to the part level. All right, what about three levels up? We have a beautiful skateboard assembly here, and then I want to be able to have a smooth version and also a grooved version. Well, how would you accomplish that? Let's go ahead and see. So I'll come back over, and this time I'm going to control tab over to the skateboard. And then I wanted to create two different configurations of this guy, and I want to be able to create a smooth version, and then I'll also right-click and add a configuration and create a grooved version. Green check. So, for my smooth version, guess what I'll do? I'll come right down into here, into the truck subassembly, and I know that configuration A is associated with something smooth. Go ahead and green check, and then since I have two instances in here, I'll do it for both. All right, green check there, and they're both smooth, thankfully. So, click on grooved. And then I'm going to come and do the same thing. I'm going to configure for this particular configuration of the assembly which configuration he's calling for. I want a grooved version, so I'm going to green check there. The front truck is grooved. And then I'll come over here and then green check here, and the back truck is grooved. So now let's test it. Smooth version, grooved version. And this daisy chain is complete all the way from the absolute top level, three levels up, all the way down to the part level. All right, so with configurations, what we basically learned here, we have two main points, with each with two subpoints. The first main point is For each desired part configuration that you have, you want to make sure that you have a corresponding assembly level configuration. And then for the second point, major point, is for each desired assembly configuration that you have, you also want to make sure that it has a corresponding higher level assembly configuration. And if you do that, you should be able to keep your configurations in order.
All right, thank you for joining us today for our video. If you'd like to see more videos, please be sure to check out our Prism Engineering YouTube channel. Also, please do join us on the second Tuesday of each month when we do our Straight from Support webinar. Thanks again for tuning in.